Today, I'll explain what is a paradox. For that, I'll talk about axioms, but also about barbers, castles, and small-town mayors. And this is math. Hi, welcome. Today I'll talk about paradoxes while being shaved old school. Imagine a small village completely isolated from civilization. Like in many others, in this village there is a church, a castle, a fountain, a pub where men argue about football, and ancient houses. Living in these houses there's an artisan, a shepherd, a widow, sheep, but also the village's official tabloid. Oh, and the barber. This barber shaves all men in this village who do not shave themselves. So far, so good. It all makes sense, just up until someone asks a seemingly innocent question. But then, who shaves the barber? Can the barber shave himself? The barber cannot shave himself because the barber only shaves those who don't shave themselves. Then can someone else shave the barber? No. If someone else is to shave the barber, then we fall again in absurdity. Because in that case, the barber doesn't shave himself. But if he shaves all men who do not shave themselves, then he should shave himself. And this is a paradox. Confused? The fact is, it is confusing. Even mathematical logic experts are somewhat muddled about this. At the beginning of last century, there was a group of mathematicians who believed they could rearrange mathematical knowledge by placing simple facts at the base and deduce all other assertions from these basic principles. And those principles were called axioms. Axioms are elementary facts so obvious that anyone would accept them as correct. An axiom example. Through any two points in a plane, it's possible to draw a straight line. Or that this house is made of stone. Or even that climbing this slope requires a bit of effort. Axioms would be a kind of foundation for all mathematics, or at least for some part of it. And then mathematics would be built upon these foundations. Each stone would be placed on top of the previous one, and after placing a few of them together, a structure would arise. Like a castle. A large one. This group of mathematicians began to build a part of the castle that contained a portion of mathematics called the set theory. Set theory is the field of mathematics that studies collections of objects, and it was used to create the foundations for almost all mathematics. One of the greatest set theory's enthusiasts was Bertrand Russell. But unfortunately, axioms and paradoxes made us run out of time. We'll carry on with this next week. In the next episode, we'll continue to talk about axioms, goats will continue to graze, and Rogério will visit the local mayor.
Isto é matemática.
This is math.